In this movie, we're going to look at how to use a book template to create a brand new book in Bloom. To create a brand new book, first select a suitable book template. Basic book is the most general. Some of the templates have a very specific purpose. For example, this one is only useful for making a wall calendar. We will learn the basics of how to use a template by using basic book. To use it, click on the template. Then confirm that you really want to add a new book based on this template by clicking Make a Book Using This Source. Bloom adds a new book based on this template to your collection of books and opens it in the Edit tab. Bloom knows about the basic requirements for any book type of publication, so some special pages come built in. The front cover, the credits page, which includes a space for copyright and licensing information, the title page, and a back page with space for text. The first two pages and the last two pages are not white. These pages will be printed on the book's cover, which will probably be made of thicker paper such as cardstock. On all the special built-in pages, any text areas which have a specific purpose have this indicated for you with a yellow speech bubble. Follow these prompts to enter the information in the right places. On all pages in Bloom, text areas are shown as a little box, which gains a blue border when you click it. The boxes themselves will not be visible in the printed book, just the text. Bloom knows where else it's conventional to show the title, namely on the title page. So the title is automatically displayed on the title page as well. You can edit the title here. And if you do so, that correction is shown on the front page as well. In Bloom, spaces for pictures are shown with this flower shape. If you do not add a picture, the final book will be blank in this space. The flower is not shown. To add a picture, hover the mouse over the flower. Two buttons appear. The top one allows you to select a saved image, the bottom one to paste in an image which has been copied to your clipboard. We will use the top one this time. In the dialogue that opens, the Art of Reading gallery is shown selected. This is a library of pictures which can be used in publications. To find a suitable picture in the library, type a key term in the box and click the magnifying glass or press enter to start the search. Pictures which match the key term are shown in the window. Scroll down to see all the possibilities. Clicking a picture allows you to see it larger and to read its copyright and licensing information. You can also search for pictures using some other languages. When you have decided which picture to use, click on the picture and then click OK. You then see the selected picture inserted onto the page of your book. It is automatically resized and centered to nicely fit the picture slot on the page. As you may have noticed, there are other ways to add pictures, which we will cover in a separate movie. To add pages to your book, click Add Page. The Add Page dialog box appears. Here, Bloom is offering you a choice of page layouts. These pages are all blank, but are pre-configured to display the text and any pictures on the page in different ways. In general, the difference between the template pages is about picture placement. This one has the picture on top with text underneath. And this one is the other way round with text above a picture. This one has no picture at all. So you need to be thinking about whether you want a picture, and if so, where on the page, as you add pages. All of the page choices which have a preview provide a good layout. This means you can focus all your efforts on adding content, what you are writing, and the pictures you select. For those who do need more options, there are ways to customize the page layout. When you have chosen which page layout you wish to use this time, select it by clicking it and then click Add This Page. We'll repeat that to add a few more pages. When you add the first page, it appears between the front and back matter pages. And when we add other pages, they are added after the currently selected page, unless that page is a front or a back page, in which case the new page is added before. It is entirely up to you which page layouts you add to your book, how many, and what variety you use. You can reorder pages by clicking and dragging to reorder them. You can also delete a page with the Remove Page button. You need to confirm the deletion by clicking Remove. To add text to a page you have added, click the empty box and it will be outlined in blue. In any text box, the current language is shown in the bottom right corner. On this page, there are two text boxes. I can add text above the picture and below the picture. I click in the second text box to enter text there. At any time when you are creating or editing a book, you can decide to show two or three languages in the book instead of just one. To add another language, click the One Language button at the top of the screen. Select the other language to display. Bloom adds text boxes for English onto our pages as well. I can now add English on the pages too. By clicking Collections, I can return to view all the books in this collection. You can see that the new book we have been working on throughout this video is now listed here. If I want to work on it again another time, I click it and then click Edit This Book. In this video, we use the basic book template to create a new empty book in our collection of books. We then added a title and a cover picture. We added some pages to the book using Add Page. We removed one of those pages and reordered another. We added text to some of the pages. We also looked at how to show the text in more than one language in the book if desired.